Welcome all. In this video, I will show you how to use for loops in C++. If you have a statement like this one, and you want to print out this onto the screen, not that difficult to do. But what if I had to print out 1,000 lines? That would be a huge waste of time to define each one of these lines individually, and I had to do something more complex for every single line. Instead, I will use the for loop. You can define the for loop by using the for keyword, then you open up the parentheses, type in two colons, which symbolize three fields. So you have a field after the last semicolon, between the two semicolons, and before the first semicolon. Then you open up curly braces, you save, and this is the most basic form of the for loop that you can possibly write. If I open up these, and if I say that I would like this to be placed here, and I will delete these down below, I will save, build, and then I will run. Cool, it starts repeating, but this is no good. It keeps on repeating on end. What's going on here? Well, this is an infinite for loop. Loops, if they're not properly constructed, they can end up spinning on end. And you might have unreachable code down below because there's no termination condition for this. This will never finish. So we need to define some parameters here in order to make our loop go to a certain extent and then stop or self-terminate. So I'll say here int I is equal to 0. Usually referred to as index or iterator or something. Then you say I is less than 10. This is a condition which will be evaluated for each iteration of the loop. It will ask, is I less than 10? True or false? True, continue with the loop. False, terminate the loop. And then here I will say I plus plus. So I will increase the value of I for every single iteration. Since the value of I increases for every single iteration, it will inevitably become 10 or greater than 10 when this is evaluated as false. That's it. This loop will self-terminate. So save, build, run, and voila. I indeed have 10 printouts, but I can go ahead and change this to an I and save it and then build and then run. It goes from 0, so there's no need for a 10 in the end. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that's 10 digits. However, if I delete these, this one line will still work. Why will it work? Well, it will be considered part of the body of the for loop if it's just one line. If I have another line right below it, this one will not be considered to be part of the for loop body. And it's red, which means there are problems. What's happening? It says that symbol I could not be resolved. Why? I have the I declared and initialized right here. Well, this is true, but this I is declared and initialized only and only within the scope of this for loop. It does not exist outside of it. However, if I cut it out and put it outside of the for loop, then this I will exist and it will be a zero here as I have initialized it to a zero here. And let's not forget the semicolon. So build, run, and voila. It goes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Why is it 10? What is happening? 9 was the last number to be printed out, and this is iterated here, but the last iteration was 10. I will become 10, and then this condition here will become invalid. So this evaluation will become false. It's going to print out 9, and then it's going to go outside of the for loop, and it's going to take the last value of I, which is actually 10, because I needed to become 10 in order for the condition to fail. And I can type in something like this. Outside, save, build, run, and there you go. So indeed, it is outside. So I became 10. This condition here became invalid because I was now equal to 10. It was not less than 10. And hence, it failed. So it just stopped printing and line number 12 was executed. It printed out the last value of I, which was 10. I'm sure you figured it out by now that I have print up here and I have defined this line as print just so that I don't have to type it in over and over again. Just seemed a little bit simpler to me. There are logic errors that can take place. So let me just demonstrate that as well. If, for example, I is minus minus here, that would mean that the value of I will continue to decrease. And since the value of I will continue to decrease, this condition will never become false. This will always be true because I will always be less than 10 because it is not increasing anywhere in the code. And that means that we will get an unintentional infinite for loop, which is horrible because it's a logic error that will compile and run, and it will not be reported by the compiler that there is a problem. Sometimes IDEs will tell you that this code is unreachable due to the conditions that happened here, that this condition will basically never evaluate to false. So they might warn you. So make sure to check your loops to figure out where the problem lies. If you like these sort of videos, and if you would like more of this, please feel free to like, subscribe, and comment. We would love to hear from you.